Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Now, in this video, I am going to talk about Grand Center Dispatch or dispatch queues or threading or whatever you would like to call them. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, let me just show you what we are going to build out, and in the meantime you will learn about Grand Central Dispatch and threading on an iOS app. So let's just build this test so you may see what we are going to create and talk about. So there is a label waiting for result and fetch data from server. Okay, we are going to push on the button and we are going to wait for 3 seconds, and the result is 1. The label has been changed to the result what we have fetched from the server. Now, of course, this is a dummy fetching because we are not having any server back to our app, but we are mimicking the way that iOS uses fetching, meaning that we are going to fetch this data on a background thread. Now, what are background threads and main threads? Well, basically, on the main thread, the main thread is used to manage all of the UI. What you see is on the main thread. That is for the utmost importance. Now, everything from data fetching or data processing is handled on a background thread. Now, for instance, if you are using Firebase, everything is fetched on the background thread, and then you need to, let's say, refresh your table view to populate the data, and that refresh needs to be done on the main thread. So basically, on the main thread, you handle the UI. On the background thread, you handle all of the fetching and processing and so on. So we are going to simulate this fetch data from server on a background thread. Now, enough talking. Let's just stop this and go ahead and click the link down below, and you will see the resources, and you will get the link to my GitHub repository, and it is called Easy GCD Grand Center Dispatch. And go ahead and clone it or download it, and you will see something like this. Let's say you download it, and without this pod file log and the pods, you will have a pod file. Now, what you want to do is update this pod file. And let's open up terminal here and simply type in cd and a space, and just go ahead and drag and drop the root folder of your project into terminal, hit return and type in pod update. Okay, hit return again. Of course, all of my pods are up to date, and this will take a while, but go ahead and wait for it, and you would be able to launch the project. You will not have any errors, and we are using pods here because we are using tiny constraints as usual to constrain our views, and we are basically constraining the label and the button on that view controller. So let's wait for this to finish, and it should finish in just a moment, and then we will be able to launch our project. Till then, I am going to walk you through this project. Okay, basically we are having a root view controller, and that is added as a root view controller to our window, and we are adding it to our navigation stack there. And let me just open that up. As you can see, it closed this because the update has finished. So let's go to terminal. Yes, indeed it did. Okay, let's go to our root view controller. But before we do that, we have here a dispatch queue helper file. I won't click into that so we don't ruin the end of it. So that will be a helper file once you understand what we are going to build. So let's go into the root view controller. Here we have our button, our label, and we are setting up the views, we are setting the background color to be white, adding the two views, the button and the label, and constraining it on our view controller. And for the button, we have a selector. Once we tap on that button, we are calling on the button tab, and that button tab is calling grab data from a database. So here we are, and that is the basic of our project. Okay, now let's just start off by knowing what we want to do. Basically, we want to fetch a background thread and, let's say, fetch some data on that. So what you would do is go ahead and type in, and here you have some options to choose from. And as you can see, we have async with a code or execute, or you can execute a group or async after. We will talk about async after in just the finishing of this video. So let's just choose this one. Async group quos, that is dispatch QoS, and so on. What we want to have here, this is an optional, so we just can simply delete that. Now you can see that we can choose background, default, unspecified, and so on. So we are going to choose background, and we are not going to use any flags for now, and execute is the code that you want to execute on the background thread. So let's say let's print out here, just add a D here. So let's build and run and see what happens. Well, basically a print statement will be added to the log. Nothing really changes. Let's just click on that, on the background thread now, and it is instant. Now, if we wanted to change, let's say, the text of our label, like label dot text equals to on the background or something like that, and of course we need to add in here cell because we are in a completion, this setting of the text of the label will be, let's so call it, unprecise. It is not immediate because it's on the background thread. Whether the system has any memory or resources, it will go ahead and update the text of the label. That is why we always have to, and this is by default, we always have to set the text of the label on the main thread. But if we are on the background thread, we shouldn't set the label text or any UI changes once we are on the background thread. Yes. So let's just build and run and see if this on the background basically comes up instantly or something like that. It can vary, it can last for a few seconds, or it can be even instant, but it's tricky. So let's hit on that. And yeah, it is still waiting for result, and you get an error: UI label text must be used from a main thread only. And as you can see, it doesn't really update at all. Okay, what you want to do here is come back to the main thread. And yeah, this is basically mimicking the background of, let's say, a Firebase call. So what we want to go do is call dispatchQ.main.async, and I will call this code or execute, it doesn't really matter. Let's call this code, and let's just grab that and paste that in there, and let's print out now. We are on the main thread now. Okay, and on the main thread, because we are on the main thread now. Now this should be instant, so let's just build and run again, and let's tap on the button and on the main thread. Great. Okay, or we should go with, let's say we fetch the result here on the background. So let's see, let data, or let's call it result equals one, it will be a simple integer. And now we are going to add in here result. Okay, let me just check, waiting for result. Yes, and result is there. So let's just build and run again, and we should see result equals to 1. So we did fetch the result on the background thread, and we are displaying the result on a main thread. So there we go, instant, great. Okay, now we should be able to, let's say, wait for a few seconds. So let's mimic that too. Now we could do something like this, like sleep, let's say, for 3 seconds. Now this has its own issues. Like, sleep really means that we are freezing everything on the app, so we cannot tap on anything. We are just freezing it, and as you can see, the result is 1. Okay, but that isn't quite convenient. So what I like to use is async after. So let me just comment all of this out. Maybe we will use this later on, but let's just build out. So let's type in dispatch queue dot global and async after, and I will choose this one, deadline, dispatch time, and execute. So let's create a dispatch time here, let, and it has some uptime nanoseconds. So let's add in here 3, I believe that should be great, and add in here the dispatch time that we have created, and we are going to execute. Maybe we want to come back to our main thread now, because, let's just copy this out, because all of this is inside our dispatch queue background thread. Okay, let me just uncomment this, maybe copy it, can comment it out. Yeah, a lot of copy and pasting here, but you get the idea. So let's take that, and there we go. Okay, now this kind of looks cumbersome, but it will do the job. Okay, let's build and run again and see what happens. Okay, let's tap on the button. Oh, and yeah, we need dispatch time dot now, and let's add in here some seconds, and the seconds need to be of type double, and it will be 3 seconds. So yeah, you need to add in a double as of the dispatch time now. So let's build and run and see what happens. Yeah, and as you can see, this is kind of cumbersome. So yeah, let's tap on that now. As you can see, it's in on the background thread, and we, after 3 seconds, we did fetch the result, and we did set it on the main thread as result equals 1. Okay, now that is pretty awesome, but it's kind of a lot of code, and you should have a wrapper around it, or maybe let's call it a helper. Okay, and that is where a dispatch queue helper comes in. I have created it, and you can use it to your liking. Now, let's go into that file and see what it actually is. Well, it is called dispatch queue helper, and we have set the initializer, the basic initializer, to be file private, because we don't want any other people to initialize it. Now we have here a function called, and it is a static public function, delay by seconds, and of course the seconds is a double, and the dispatch level is of type dispatch level, and it is set, if you are not adding it, as main, but you can also add it. And here we have a completion. Don't worry about the completion, we will be talking about the completion in the next video. So what is this dispatch level? Well, it is the thread that you actually want to choose. So I've added here some cases, well, all of the cases, the main, user interactive, user initiated, utility, and background. What you need to know about is the background and the main. And it is basically, you already know this, dispatch queue.main, dispatch queue.global, user interactive, and we have used this background one. Okay, and this dispatch level is used in this function that we are going to call. And it basically what it does is sets a dispatch time like we just did in a few minutes ago from dispatch time now, and it adds in the second, so that is what we are going to wait for, and uses as this dispatch queue async and with a deadline, and we are going to execute this completion. Again, don't worry about the completion, we are going to talk that in the next video. Okay, so how do we actually use this? Well, it is pretty straightforward. Let's just comment all of this out and write our new call, and you will see that is pretty easy. So let's call dispatch queue helper. Okay, and delay by seconds, and as you can see, we have a dispatch level option or without. If we don't choose any dispatch level, then it is set, of course, to the default dot main thread. But for now, let's just choose our background and let's just delay this by 3 seconds. And the dispatch level should be background. There we go. And completion. Now, once this is completed, so let's just add in the result here. So we have grabbed the result after 3 seconds. And now we want to set this result on the labels text property. So dispatch queue helper, of course you could use dispatch queue main.async in this scenario, but let me just show you how we would delay by 0 seconds, so it's immediate, and of course we are not using a dispatch level in this function, so the main is set by default, and we are going to set the labels text to be result.1. So let me just build and run one last time, and yeah, it's a lot more easier, more comprehensive, and easier to write. So tapping on fetch data from server, 1, 2, 3, and result equals 1. Great. So now you know how you can use grant center dispatch and dispatch queue dot main or dot background and what it all means. And of course, you are given a present with dispatch queue helper. It is very easy to use, and yeah, go ahead and download it and use it in your code to your liking. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell. I dare you. And as always, I will see you in the next one.